Today, we embark on an exhilarating expedition with the James Webb Space Telescope, a marvel of modern technology that holds the key to unlocking the secrets of distant worlds. Imagine peering into the closest star system to us, Proxima Centauri, just 4 light years away, and witnessing peculiar anomalies on one of its planets, Proxima B. These anomalies, known as artificial lights, have ignited a frenzy of speculation among scientists worldwide. Could they be signs of intelligent life beyond Earth? Join us as we unravel the enigma surrounding these mysterious city lights and delve deep into the implications they hold for our understanding of the cosmos. But we need your expertise on this cosmic quest. Share your thoughts and theories in the comments below. What do you think these artificial lights signify? Are we on the brink of a groundbreaking discovery? The only place where we know life exists is Earth. Throughout history, humans have wondered if life exists beyond our planet. In 1984, American astronomers Jill Tarter and Thomas Pearson initiated the search for extraterrestrial intelligence, SETI, project to explore this question. SETI aims to detect space-based radio signals, which can travel far and are more likely to be picked up by the 42 radio telescopes of the Allen Telescope Array in the Californian Cascade Mountains. Despite decades of searching, no concrete evidence of extraterrestrial life has been found. Later on, the James Webb Space Telescope launched successfully, enhancing our ability to explore distant planets orbiting stars far away. This colossal telescope, situated around 1 million miles from Earth, is equipped with ultra-sensitive detectors. It opens up new avenues for studying uncharted territories in the cosmos. 20 years ago, there were no known planets outside those in our solar system. Since then, more than 4,000 exoplanets have been discovered orbiting other stars. NASA suggests there might be trillions of exoplanets out there in the universe. The first hints of life beyond our solar system could come from plants on these distant worlds. During its journey to Jupiter, the Galileo spacecraft took a peek back at Earth and found a clear sign of plant life. It spotted what's known as the vegetation red edge biosignature, a blend of red and infrared lights that plants reflect. Imagine a planet like ours, covered in dense forests. It should give off a strong and noticeable signal called VRE. With the James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, we're gearing up to scan faraway Earth-like planets in the cozy zone around stars. These planets could hold vital clues about life in their atmospheres. When sunlight touches a planet's atmosphere, the JWST might catch it as it sneaks in. Any missing light wavelengths can then be captured using spectroscopy. This method lets us identify the unique fingerprint of atoms and molecules in the atmosphere, helping us spot signs of life. This method may be used to determine the composition of the atmosphere and whether life is possible. Life could exist on Earth-sized planets with atmospheres similar to our own, with a predominance of oxygen, nitrogen, and carbon dioxide. By looking for elements that aren't usually present, one may be able to detect technological life. Chlorofluorocarbons, CFCs, generated for use in refrigeration and cleaning products, would probably be noticeable to aliens monitoring Earth's atmosphere from a distance. If the JWST found CFCs in planetary atmospheres, that would be a clear indication of civilization. Actually, life on exoplanets might not even remotely resemble life on Earth. Sometimes, even earthly life, like extremophiles, species that can endure in environments where other living things would perish, can seem alien. This is a group of organisms, primarily bacteria, that can withstand extreme conditions. Some humans can withstand heat up to 250 degrees Fahrenheit, while others can survive in strong acids with pH levels below 3. since planets like Earth are more likely to support life than planets with severe temperatures or acidic conditions, it could be a good idea to start with those first. Prime candidates could have temperatures that allow liquid water to exist on their surfaces and orbit a stable star. The classification for our Sun is a yellow G-type star. These stars are less common and typically have shorter lives. However, in our universe, the likelihood of studying planets orbiting around red dwarf stars, which are more frequent and have lower luminosities and temperatures than the Sun, is higher. There is more time for the formation of life and evolution to produce complex life forms because these stars have longer lifespans. Around 40 light years away from Earth, the TRAPPIST-1 planetary system will be the subject of JWST's first mission. It revolves around a calm red dwarf star with 7 Earth-sized rocky planets. 3 of the rocky planets in the so-called habitable zone might have liquid water on their surfaces. Despite having a much smaller and colder mass than our Sun, the TRAPPIST-1 star radiates light that is similar to that of Earth, due to the close orbit of its planets. The best chance for humans to see city lights outside the solar system is Proxima Centauri, a red dwarf star that is 4.25 light years from the Sun and our nearest star. Proxima is about 600 times fainter than the Sun, so a planet must be 20 times closer to it than Earth is to the Sun in order for it to support life based on liquid water. In August 2016, astronomers discovered a planet with 1.3 Earth masses in this habitable region, a Goldilocks-like habitable zone where the light intensity is just right to melt water. Proxima B circles Proxima Centauri. It's possible that Proxima B is an airless, lifeless planet, given that it orbits its red dwarf star, Proxima Centauri, at a distance of only 4.6 million miles. The planet Proxima B is in a close orbit that exposes it to strong solar winds that can completely destroy its atmosphere. It also provides enough sunlight for temperatures and liquid water similar to those on Earth. Because of its close proximity to the star, Proxima B is thought to be tidally locked, always showing the same side to the star as the Moon does in reference to Earth. Proxima Centauri is about 18% the mass of the Sun and burns far less brightly than one might anticipate for a planet so near to its star, just 5% of the Earth's Sun distance, which may be anticipated to be a red, hot cinder. Liquid water could easily exist on Proxima B as long as the planet has an atmosphere to hold heat in, since the total energy reaching it from the Sun is only 65% of what Earth receives. So, while Proxima B might not be our dream home, it's still a fascinating world to study. But hey, that doesn't mean we should overlook Proxima B. In fact, studying it can teach us a lot about the weird and wonderful worlds out there in the cosmos. And who knows, maybe one day we'll find a hidden gem among the stars. So keep exploring.